Before you came round, my heart would never be much faster. Before you came round, I was ready to slow down.
Hello guys, and welcome to Aseel by Sketchbook. My name is Aseel, I'm an interior designer, and this is my first YouTube video. So guys, I would like to have my first YouTube video represent one of the first initial elements in any design, interior design or not, and that is mood board. What is a mood board, you might ask? Good question. Well, a mood board is a collection of inspirational images and materials and texts, anything that inspires you to complete a design, regardless of the type of the design that you're doing. You can think about mood board as a tool to help you visualize the room or the project that you're working on before you do it. Illustrate to the client what you have in mind so you can see what they have in theirs and like confirm if they like something or not. I'm gonna put it really quickly here that I used to use Photoshop, but what I'm doing right now, since I have some load of work on my hand, that I use PowerPoint to create my mood boards, which is a little bit unusual. We started doing this back in the day when I was an interior designer in IKEA, and I kept going because it's really efficient. And it puts everything together, so if you're presenting something for the client, it's already there. You can delete an image on the spot if you would like. Let me show you inside of my computer, like in depth, how to create a mood board using PowerPoint. Well, as you can see guys here, now we are officially inside of my computer. And I have prepared for you this example of a layout of a mood board. But it's totally up to you how you arrange the components of the mood board. As long as you have all of those things in it, you know. So basically we have the main mood image, which will set the tone for the rest of the mood board, but it will also set the tone for the final design, and it will connect between the final design and the brief. So when, for example, if your client told you that they wanted an industrial space with like a hint of tropical, what you want to do is look for a picture that will represent that mood, that precise mood. For the sake of this project, I found this picture and I thought it was perfect for like an industrial space with a concrete walls and like a hint of tropical, as you can see. So to me, this is my main image, which I will build on this mood board. Now what I want to do is that I want to enhance the fact that concrete is a main element. It has like a very strong presence. So I want to enhance that and convey to my client that I'm going to be using concrete in their project, in their space. So basically what I will try to do is I will go to Pinterest and I'll type in concrete texture, and I'll find the best presentation for my concrete. To me, this is perfect, so I'll just copy it. Obviously, you don't want to do this for commercial purposes, but yeah. And I've just pasted it on my space, my working space here. Now, I like this, but I think it's too bulky, so I want to soften it up a little bit. So I'm going to crop it as a circle. You do that by going to Picture Tools, Format, and Crop, Crop to Shape. And finally, you select whatever shape you would like. You click on crop again, and you can adjust your circle to the preferred size that you would like. But I also need to tell you that this canvas that you're working on, you can adjust the size for it. This is just the standard size because I honestly don't have the need to like print it more than A3, and this is totally fine. But if you would like to adjust the size, then you just go to design and slide size, custom slide size, and you put in whatever dimensions that you want this to be printed in. But anyways, going back to that topic, I have the concrete as an element here. I like it, I'm gonna keep it as it is, and I'm gonna copy some other shapes from a previous work of mine. So for now, I want to add like a little bit of metallic texture, which is like silver, but it's a little bit of like rusty silver.
So I would like to use that as a part of my design. So I can see right now that one of the missing elements that I want to enhance a little bit more to show more is the rattan here. So basically I want like a bench or something, anything that shows the texture of that. And I've already went to Pinterest and I found this magnificent chair that like it's perfect for an industrial space because of the leather and at the same time because of the rattan. So I'm gonna copy this image, paste it. Now the best trick, hold on, oh this is IKEA, hello there. Okay, so I basically I'm cropping to get to the image that I want. This is a beautiful chair. Okay, and I can see that there is a white background and I don't like that because I like my images to be perfectly like cropped. Like if I want to add the white background, I'll add it myself by having like a shape, but I don't like this. So what can I do about it? Because this is not Photoshop, but I will teach you how to make it look like it is Photoshopped. You can go to, after selecting the picture, you can go to picture tools, remove background, as simple as that. Drag your box to just where you want it to be. And there you go. Now, this is a perfect example. It will not always be like this. Let's say I have a, like a log of wood. Just let's say that. Let's say I have something like that, like this log of wood that I would like to add here. And let's say that I want to add this image, but I don't want the background because I've already put my interest in concrete here. So I'm going to do the exact same thing. I'm going to remove background. Now, as you can see, the shadow as well of the log of the tree, it is there as well. So I want to get rid of it. What do I do? You can just basically do the same thing. Picture tools, remove background, and mark areas to remove. Now, if I do this, it will remove like the portion where it's darker. It can tell what color needs to go. And mark areas to keep with mark areas to keep. Bam, you have it. There you have it. Of course, I'm gonna crop it anyways because I did that to show you, but I want a little bit of, like, all I want is like a little bit of presence for the wood here, for the dark wood. So I'm gonna do that. To keep your mood board dynamic and interesting, you need to add elements that are not like square or like fitted within a box per se. You have to think how you can make it more interesting than that. Making each material defined by a shape, it will give it that dynamic touch that it really needs. Now, if we look at this beautiful chair right here, I'm really in love with the chair. I'll just look into where I can buy it. I can see that the colors, it's too bright for the vibe that I'm looking for in this photo. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to edit it like you're editing in Photoshop. So this is very cool. It's very interesting. If you go to, again, picture tools, color, and you go to picture color options, you have this entire window where you have the saturation, color tone presets. So what I want to do is I want to lessen the saturation of this. So as you can see, you've kept the rattan and you desaturated, which is exactly what I needed to do. And now it matches the vibe of this picture a little bit more, except I want to desaturate this picture a little bit. So what I want to do right now is I want to add a color scheme. So how can I do that? I'm not in Photoshop. What I need to do is I need to go to Insert. And then you go to shapes. You pick out rectangle and you just drag it for as much as you need it.
Now, as you can see, it's blue, and that's totally fine. I will cancel out the outline because I don't want an outline for my shape, but I want the shape fill with an eyedropper. As you can see, it's also in the drawing tools. And I can see the most dominant color in this picture is gray, which is like my main key color here. And ta-da! Okay, another trick here is I want to crop this image, like to fit it within this border from the YouTube title box. And yet I want to keep the gray background because it will look really cool if I can just like keep the curvature of the plant with cropping this. So what I did is I copied the image twice. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove the background from one of them. And now I have no background for this, and now I am going to crop it. As you can see, the background remained. You can do this in a different way. You can do it in 100 ways, but it looks dynamic. This is the thing, you are thinking outside of the box, literally. And now the only thing that I'm missing right here is basically the keywords of this image. This is how I do it, but feel free to put your keywords first. I've already done this yesterday, so I'm gonna take my keywords. I've just selected everything by clicking Ctrl A, and I'm just gonna center the whole thing. So right now I'm pretty happy with the result. This is my end product mood board. I'm just gonna delete this. And you're going to find this mood board alongside with this PowerPoint presentation on my blog, so I will link it down below. So guys, if you stayed here up until now, thank you very much for watching. I appreciate it. And if you'd like to see more interior design and lifestyle videos, please click on subscribe. It's either here or here. And hit that bell if you want to receive notifications every time I upload. I'm going to be uploading every Saturday, inshallah. Yeah, it was a blast. Thank you for tuning in. High five.